Thoroughbred Action is presented by Hardacre Farm.
Welcome to Thoroughbred Action from Gulfstream Park. I'm your host, Acacia Courtney. It's a beautiful Friday afternoon. I'm here from the roof looking over the beautiful racetrack. There are 9 races on the card today, so let's get right to the track and weather conditions.
The track is sloppy and the turf is listed as firm. Race number 1 is 5 furlongs on the turf, a claiming race with a purse of $24,000 for 3-year-olds and up, which have never won 2 races or 3-year-olds. Scratch the number 8, the main track only, Baduke.
Racing at Gulfstream. Gasolina off a step slow. The favorite Drama Club begins nicely. Down toward the inside, Mr. Kisses is showing speed. Moving up on the outside goes I'm No Secret. I'm No Secret now to put ahead in front. Drama Club is second. Zeus Odin moving up on the outside of Mr. Kisses. Then comes Ikatiro, followed by stablemate Gasolina, and Nook is the trailer. They speed around the far turn. I'm No Secret is now leading by a length for Jaramillo. From second, Drama Club trying to keep his spot, and he's battling right back here. From third is Zeus Odin. Stretch of 2 to Mr. Kisses. Then comes the outside horse Ikatiro, at the back Gasolina, and trailing is Nook. They run to the top of the stretch. They went 22 seconds for the opening quarter. Drama Club cuts the corner, battles right back, and takes a narrow lead. I'm No Secret is now second, swung to the center. Ikatiro's punching home. Then Zeus Odin and Mr. Kisses. Final furlong. Drama Club still there. Toward the inside, here's Mr. Kisses with a late run outside Ikatiro. Drama Club is hanging on. Drama Club wins by a length and a half. Second is Ikatiro. Third is Mr. Kisses. Then I'm No Secret in 57 flat.
Number 5, Drama Club wins the opener and delivers at even money. Ridden to victory by Eddie Castro, trained by Dave Fox, and owned by Sandra New. Race number 2 is 1 mile on the main track. A maiden claiming in the purse is $27,000 for fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up. The number 1, Little Alexandra, is a late scratch.
And they're off. Rock Solid Lady broke a bit awkwardly. Liberty Road begins nicely, and so does the first-timer Queen of Gems from down toward the inside. These two are quickest from Charming Fantasy, who comes away racing in third. Rock Solid Lady is an early fourth, and it's 5 or 6 to Night Storm, who's last of all as they exit the one-mile chute. Liberty Road has the lead, but Queen of Gems comes through on the inside to poke ahead in front. Out wide is Rock Solid Lady. In touch from fourth is Charming Fantasy. These top 4 separated by about a length and a half. And then it's 6 to Night Storm. Quarter time, very slow, 24-4 as they run down the backstretch. Liberty Road and Amisa El Jaramillo ahead in front. Gaff Leone protects inside position with Queen of Gems right alongside second. Rock Solid Lady is third for Jesus Rios, followed by Charming Fantasy. She's asked to quicken a little bit here by Castro, fourth behind the speed, and then it's far back to Night Storm. 48-2 for the opening half mile. They sped it up in the second quarter. Liberty Road the leader. Rock Solid Lady comes to call on the outside. Queen of Gems appears to be all finished today. Up on the outside, and Charming Fantasy now takes third as they run past the 5/16. With the lead, it's Liberty Road, nursed on the front end, ahead in front of Rock Solid Lady. Charming Fantasy's put to a full-out drive. She's 1 pace from third after 3 quarters and 1:12-2. They turn for home. Liberty Road cuts the corner and is shaken up for the drive. From second, Rock Solid Lady, then Charming Fantasy and Queen of Gems. There's 1/8 of a mile to go, and Liberty Road is looking good. Liberty Road widens on a 3-length lead now. Rock Solid Lady clearly second, then Charming Fantasy, Liberty Road, easily by 3. Rock Solid Lady, then Charming Fantasy. The battle's going to be on for 4th, and getting up 4th is Night Storm in 1:38 flat.
Number 4, Liberty Road, wins the second race, breaking her maiden in her 12th start. Ridden by Emmy Sale Jaramillo, trained by Marty Wolfson, and owned by Miller Racing. Let's take a break. We'll be back after these words. Race number 3 is 7.5 furlongs on the turf, a maiden claiming with a purse of $17,000 for 3-year-olds and up. Scratch the 1, Ariba Causeway, and the 9, main track only, Giant Inca.
And they're off. From the outside, Wonder Frolic begins nicely. Forever Die is showing speed today. In between horses, Daddy Duke with Leroy's Image from down toward the inside. Off to speed next goes Traffic Express, and the two at the back are All Hundreds and Runaway Bull. Into the first turn they go. Forever Die and Carlos Olivero on the engine today. Lead it by a length and a quarter. Leroy's Image is now moved up to be second while wanting off the fence. Not much room there. Daddy Duke keeps him pinned in. From fourth, that's Traffic Express, then Wonder Frolic. Back to the outside goes Runaway Bull, and All Hundreds is the trailer. Separated by seven lengths as they turn into the backstretch. Forever Die continues to lead it. Leads it now by almost two. Racing in second is Daddy Duke. From the outside, Traffic Express and Wonder Frolic. Wonder Frolic a three wide fourth now and starting to move up a bit. Then back to fifth now goes Leroy's Image. 2.5 clear of Runaway Bull, and All Hundreds is last. They make their way to the far turn. They carved a quarter in 24 seconds flat, and Forever Die is still there up top. Daddy Duke second, Traffic Express third. Leroy's Image on the rebid from fourth, stalling from fifth is Wonder Frolic. Here's Runaway Bull with Inside Passage, and All Hundreds is the trailer. They went 47-3 for a half mile, and they round the far turn. Forever Die still looking good up top, leads it by four. From second, Daddy Duke, Leroy's Image still yet to be given the green light from third. Then to the outside goes Runaway Bull, running on from the back is All Hundreds as they turn for home. Into the stretch they come after three quarters and 11-2, and Forever Die has an eighth of a mile more to get. Still leads it by four. Leroy's Image up the inside, down the outside, Runaway Bull, but it's a gate-to-wire win for Forever Die. Forever Die and Carlos Olivero wrapped up in the end and 3.5 in front. From far back, All Hundreds got second, close for third, Runaway Bull, or Leroy's Image in 131 flat.
Number four, Forever Die, pulls the upset, ridden by Carlos Olivero, trained by Rosemary Holmeister, and owned by James Sherman. Paid $15.20 to win. Race number four is 6 furlongs on the main track, a claiming race with a purse of $17,000. Four fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up, which have never won two races. The one, Lady Nura, will be ridden by Leonel Reyes, and the four, Nasha Nadesta, will be ridden by Luca Panici. Scratch the six, Stacy's Reflection.
They're off. Pink Mama blasts out of there to take the lead from the second choice, Playa Zaragoza, who comes away second to the inside, Lady Nura now third. Stretch of two to Nasha Nadezja, and it's six already to Paulo's Delight. Pink Mama's loose on the lead for Alvaro Donis, leads it by 2.5. Second is Lady Nura, third is Playa Zaragoza. From fourth is Nasha Nadezja, and 15 to the trailer, Paulo's Delight. Past the half mile and kicking it to the far turn. They went 22-2 for the opening quarter speed, and Pink Mama throttles open again today, leads it by 5. From second, that's Lady Nura to the outside, and third is Playa Zaragoza. Nasha Nadezja tries to make ground from the back as they go past the 5/16. Pink Mama controls her own fate here. She's in front by 6. From second, Lady Nura. From third, Playa Zaragoza. They're both being worked on. Nasha Nadezja is yet to make contact with those two. Meanwhile, Pink Mama continues to lead. 44-4 for the opening half mile. Pink Mama, the whip is out, but she's still there. Trying to get to her now, Playa Zaragoza and Lady Nura, then Nasha Nadezja. Final furlong, Pink Mama shortening up, but still in front. Second, Playa Zaragoza, but the favorite winner, it's Pink Mama, coast to coast, to win it by almost 3. Second, Playa Zaragoza. Third, Lady Nura. Fourth, Nasha Nadezja. 111-1.
Number two, Pink Mama, wins the fourth race, ridden by Alvaro Donis, trained by Angel Rodriguez, and owned by Frank Carl Calabrese. The fifth race today is 5 furlongs on the turf, a claiming race with a purse of $16,000 for the 3-year-olds and up, which have never won three races, or 3-year-olds. Scratch the main track only is the 9, El Gran Gallego, and the 10, Social Request. Please note that the 1, Tailstone, will wear blinkers.
And they're off. Remembering Richie blasts out of the gate and tries to clear Tailstone in the early stages with Can't Stop the Kid away in the top flight. Then comes Global Magician, who's in a bit tight, passed by Casey Wegman. Then Greg Rules, the second last Mad Patriot, and the early trailer is Tell Me a Joke. They speed into the far turn, chasing the speed of Remembering Richie, who leads it by a neck. Can't Stop the Kid draws up alongside second, 2.5 clear of Casey Wegman third. Tailstone toward the rail is fourth, followed by the odds-on choice Global Magician fifth, and given the go-ahead by Baracco. Greg Woolsey on his outside. Why does the vol tell me a joke? And Mad Patriot is the trailer as they run past the quarter pole. Toward the inside, remembering Richie, to the outside, can't stop the kid. They're in lockstep. Four lengths better than Casey Wegman and Global Magician. Up the rail and Tailstone. Eighth of a mile to go. On top, remembering Richie, fending off the challenge from Can't Stop the Kid. Global Magician coming on late. It's remembering Richie holding firm. Remembering Richie will win it. Close then for second, Can't Stop the Kid or Global Magician. Mad Patriot ran on to complete supers in 57 flat.
Number 8, Remembering Richie, wins the fifth race, ridden by Luis Castillo, trained by Jacob Palacios Molina, and owned by Laura Wipisinski. Let's take a break. We'll be back after these words.
Passion for horses and a commitment to breed champions is the foundation of Hardacre Farm. Founded in 1999 by Amy Tarrant, owner, breeder, and trainer, Hardacre Farm, now based in Ocala, continues its tradition of success. From the Breeders' Cup to Gulfstream Park, Hardacre Farm. From the breeding shed to the racetrack, in pursuit of producing the best.
Race number 6 is 6 furlongs on the main track, an allowance optional claiming with a purse of $43,000 for 3-year-olds and up. Please note that the main track is now listed as muddy.
And they're up. From the outside, Prague gets the first call and tries to clear the field early. Social Roy has speed, and down at the rail, that's Ranger and Paradise moving closer. These three across the track. Then it's the trio of Tenango, Loudon's Gray between horses, and out wide, My Friend Flavin. Second last early is Motown Rhythm, and at the back of the pack, the trailer here is King Rontos. They go to the half-mile pole, three across the racetrack. Prague is widest of all, Ranger and Paradise along the rail, and Social Roy between horses. Tenango's had pace to chase as they whistled a quarter in 21-4. From fifth and in range is My Friend Flavin for Panici. Now running on from the back is King Rontos, then Loudon's Gray, and Motown Rhythm is last of all as they go to the top of the stretch. Off cover, here's Tenango on the attack right now. Widest of all in My Friend Flavin, up the inside, Ranger in Paradise. That's all for the early pace setter, Social Roy, and they turn for home. Tenango now takes the lead to the attack, My Friend Flavin, up the inside, Ranger in Paradise. King Rontos trying to find clear racetrack. Furlong to go. Here's My Friend Flavin up on the outside now, taking the lead and moving clear. My Friend Flavin and Luca Panici on to victory. My Friend Flavin by a length and a quarter. Second is Tenango, third Ranger in Paradise, then King Rontos and Loudon's Gray to complete the high five in 1:10-4.
Number 6, My Friend Flavin wins the sixth race, ridden by Luca Panici, trained by Leo Gabriel Jr. and owned by Robbins Family Racing. The seventh race is 5 furlongs on the turf, a maiden claiming with a purse of $15,000, 4 fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up. Scratch the 9, the main track only, Awesome Missy.
And they're off. Poor beginnings for Holy Roland and Troya. From the inside, Wallflower begins the best and goes looking for the lead alongside My Martina in the early stages. Away racing in third is Itchley, then Miss BVI. My Kind of Cat will be stuck very wide as they enter the far turn. 3 lengths better than Southern Touch. Then it's back to the inside to Troya, and Holy Roland is far back. They run around the far turn. Wallflower has the lead by a length. From second, here's Itchley moving closer for Martine Ramirez. 3 better than My Martina and Miss BVI. My Kind of Cat has no place to go while asked to quicken. It's a stretch of another 2 to Southern Touch, then Troya as they run for the top of the stretch. 22-1 for the opening quarter. Wallflower has the lead. To the attack, Itchley is second. Now swinging into the action on the outside is My Kind of Cat from third with an eighth of a mile to go. Wallflower still there. Wallflower still strong. 3 lengths to the good. My Kind of Cat begins to roll home from second. My Martina is now third. Wallflower digging in. Wallflower hanging on. My Kind of Cat second. Then My Martina up fourth was Miss BVI, and Itchley played to the fifth in 57-4.
Number 1, Wallflower takes them wire to wire. Eddie Castro in the saddle, trained by Dane Kibiski and owned by PTK LLC. Let's take a break. We'll be back in a moment.
Next January, 12 horses, $1 million buy-in for a $12 million purse. It is the world's richest race. It is the Pegasus World Cup.
Welcome back. Don't forget that tomorrow is the Summit of Speed. First post will be at 12:15 p.m. for 13 races on the card and 9 stakes races. Race number 8 today is 6 furlongs on the main track and allowance optional claiming with a purse of $37,000 for state-bred 3-year-olds and up. Scratch the 4, splash rules.
And they're off. Nicanelli wins the start from Call to Honor, who comes away in second. The heavy favorite is Last Early, Mac Daddy Mac, only about 2.5 off the lead, while in a bit tight, Son of a Derby winner on his outside. They run down the backstretch with less than 5 furlongs to negotiate, and the leader is Nicanelli, clear by a length and a half. From the outside, Son of a Derby winner, Call to Honor between horses, and tucked in, Mac Daddy Mac is improving down inside with 2 lengths to make up and less than 0.5 mile to do it. They run around the far turn. Panici and Nicanelli have had everything their own way after a 22-2 quarter time. Mac Daddy Mac now getting into the race for Rispoli while angled off the fence. Son of a Derby winner is put to a drive from third, and Call to Honor tails off last with less than 3 furlongs to run. The top pair continue to pour it on here with Nicanelli in front of Mac Daddy Mac. They've opened 5 on Son of a Derby winner, then Call to Honor. They turn home. Nicanelli, brave up top, cuts the corner and maintains a 3-length cushion. Mac Daddy Mac is flat to the boards and not gaining. Down to the inside, it's Call to Honor, then Son of a Derby winner. There's an 1/8 of a mile to go, and Nicanelli has run them off their feet here. Mac Daddy Mac has just lost second, now lost third. The winner is Nicanelli by 2.5. Second Call to Honor, third Son of a Derby winner, and Mac Daddy Mac fades to be fourth in 1:10 and 3.
Number 5, Nicanelli wins the 8th race. Second win today for Luca Panici, trained by Kathleen O'Connell and owned by Mr. Denny's Racing Stable. Race number 9 is 1 1/16 on the turf, a claiming race with a purse of $20,000 for 3-year-olds and up, which have never won 2 races.
And runners away. Good start outside for Horner Man from the rail. Weeza Gone Gray moves to challenge. Zatara splits rivals to be part of the party. So does our Cat Daddy. And Candy Jam is also not far away as they run into the first turn. From the inside, Weeza Gone Gray protects his inside position and leads the field into the first turn. From our Cat Daddy and Candy Jam second and third, Zatara sent 3 and 4 wide. Wider than him is True Diplomacy trying to duck over. Saving ground is Baco Dinero with Horner Man just behind him. Then it's our Mystical Man with Caballero first, and the early trailer is the stretch runner El Canguro. They straighten for their backstretch journey, and Weeza Gone Gray and jockey Eddie Dominguez lead the field down the backstretch after completing a quarter in 23-2. From second, it's Candy Jam, 4 wide, Zatara, our Cat Daddy, 3 wide. Meanwhile, Banco Dinero slips through on their inside for Jesus Rios, drawing closer within 2.5 of the top. Our Mystical Man tries to follow that move in front of Horner Man, then True Diplomacy, second last El Canguro, and now the trailer is Caballero first. They carved a 1/2 mile in 47-1, and they swing around the far turn. Weeza Gone Gray's led at every jump, leads it by a length. Candy Jam second, Zatara third. All dressed up here, Cat Daddy needs room, so does Banco Dinero. He's had an inside lane. Then from behind the speed is our Mystical Man, 2 better than El Canguro as they run for home now. They went 3/4 in 1:11 and 1, and they turn for home. Weeza Gone Gray's on the board at 22-1. Banco Dinero now tipped off the fence to try to get to him in the concluding stages. Three better than our Mystical Man and Zatara. Final furlong, Weeza Gone Gray, giving Dominguez plenty up top. And Weeza Gone Gray will take the Friday finale, gate to wire. Springs the upset and three in front. Our Mystical Man second, Banco De Niro third, then Elkan Girl and Horderman to complete the high five in 143 flat.
Number one, Weeza Gone Gray pulls the upset once again and takes them wire to wire. Ridden by Eddie Dominguez, trained by Javier Negrete, and owned by Carlos Munoz. Paid $46.60 to win. In the late pick five, 505 paid $7,352.05. 405 paid $44.15. There was no winner in the super high five, so there's a carryover of $1,185.83. In the pick six, 606 paid $2,708.24. There's a carryover of $4,642.73.
That's it for today. We'll see you back here for tomorrow. It's the Summit of Speed, 13 races and post time at 12:15.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
I've been working all day. Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
What do you say?
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Hit the hay.
Well, I'm tired. Let me tell you, Jack, I'm so tired. Oh, my aching back.